Hiroshi Okushima is arguably the most famous centenarian in Okinawa and probably the world. I met Ushi 5 years ago while doing an educational project on longevity. My co-leader at the time was a young educational manager by the name of Sayoko Ogata. What was it about that first meeting that made you think, I want to change my life?
My life is really, really crazy. Nothing, just working.
And I remember meeting Ushi and just seeing her as another senior. I covered her like a journalist. Meanwhile, Sayoka had a profound experience with Ushi.
When I met Ushi-san, my heart is full of energy, love, smiling. So make me so happy. I decided to change my life. And I married, and I have a baby, and quit my job. And I changed from the where I live, from Tokyo, big business city, to small green island Yakushima.
We had an opportunity to meet Ushi again today. We filed in, she was sitting regally on this chair, wrapped in a blue kimono, and we all sat down like a bunch of kindergarten students. And you instantly felt this warmth from her. And it's not something you can observe as much as you feel with these special centenaries. There's a reason that people from all over the world come to see Ushi. She's not the oldest person in Okinawa, she's 104. But yet when you get with her, you feel this wisdom that comes from walking the earth 100 years. About 3/4 of the way into the interview, I asked Sayoko if she wanted to tell Ushi her secret, and she was hesitant, but she got up, and the ensuing exchange was amazing.
Something come from inside, like my tears like kind of falling down. So I cannot explain this emotion.
This detail I notice is that when Ushi grabbed Sayoko's hand, it wasn't just an embrace, but you actually saw Ushi's thumb kind of stroking, unconsciously stroking Sayoko's hand. And it was that powerful little detail that you think is, you know, sort of the almost the unconscious genius that these successful centenarians possess. It not only gets them to old age, it gets them there well. I first looked at Ushi and I told her that she's a national treasure, that I think almost everybody is afraid of getting old. But when people come see her, they can actually look forward to getting old. She offers kind of a vision of old age that I think you actually might aspire to. When it was time to leave, I realized that, you know, I started this project really feeling ambivalent towards seniors, but after seeing an exchange like this, you couldn't help but feel the magic that comes from spending time with people who have lived long lives well.
I'm so happy now, and now I'm really, really full of love, energy, smiling. I'm not still like Ushi-san. Still, I have to train more to make people happy. But now me, I'm so happy.